Good morning, children. Today is 28th July, English video session for class 6. We are dealing with the poem, A House, A Home. This is from Honeysuckle, introduced by NCERT. We have already done the reading of the poem and the main essence of the poem. Now, we are going to do a small introduction and the summary. Children, these things need to be written in your classwork. They have to be written in your classwork. When you come from your vacation or COVID vacation, you need to submit these classworks. There is internal marks are there for your classwork. So all of you must write. There is no option. You have to write the poem first. First you have to write the poem. Put the heading at the top. Write the name of the poem. Write fully. Then you have to write. See here. A house, a home, introduction. Are you able to see? Yes. Shall I read now? Can you repeat? Just take the pick of it or pause it and you can read it. And you can write it. You must write it, okay? Now, in this poem, the poet has explained the difference between a house and a home, okay? And he elaborates on the role that family members play in a home. This is what is the introduction part. Is that clear to you? What will you write? Introduction. This is after writing the poem neatly without any spelling error, okay? Then you have to write the summary part. Leave a line. Okay, now write summary. The poet has tried to define and differentiate between a house and a home. He says that a house is made up of bricks, comma, stone and hardwood. Put a full stop there. Yes. It also has fine panes, chimney, window glass, doors, corridors, roof and tile floors. A home is another name for loving family members who take care of each other and work selflessly. Underline. Selflessly, selflessly, please don't make spelling errors, for one another, brothers, sisters, fathers and mothers, all together make a home. It is their unselfish acts of kindness and sharing towards one another that makes a house a home. Now in this summary you are able to understand how a house is getting converted into a home. In the process, how a house which is only got bricks and stone and glass and wood is getting converted into a home. A loving place where all people are united, where all people have lot of happiness to each other. Is that clear? Now, please, I'll give you 2 minutes time. Please write it in your classwork. Now, a house and a how poem explanation. Now, let us go stanza wise. Look at the first stanza. What is a house? It is a brick and stone and wood that's hard, some window glass and perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. Now see the meanings of it. You have to write the meanings also. Okay. Yard. What does a yard means? A yard is a measuring unit. Repeat all of you. Yard is a measuring unit. So 1 yard is equal to how much? 3 feet or 36 inches. A garden, corridor, outside. Which is there? Not inside the house. It is outside the house. Now, let us go to the next word. Eaves. Repeat. Eaves. The part of the roof that hangs out over the walls to provide what? Shade. So, if the sunshade. So, sunshade, rain shade. The house requires, no? So, there will be an extension, elevation, some extension of the roof. That portion is called eaves. Look at the spelling. E-A-V-E-S. The part of the roof that hangs over the wall to provide what? Shade. It also gives protection from rain, wind, etc. Okay. So, there is an elevation of the roof. Clear? Did you understand? Yes. Now, let us go to the next word, stucco. What is the meaning of stucco? Stucco means fine paint used. What do we do after the house is completed? We go for the painting, is it not? To protect the walls. Why do you paint the house? It is to protect the house. Okay. So, stucco means they are all the fine paints used on the surface. Whatever you are doing on the surface. Okay, you put cement, then you put colorful paints. These are called stucco. Whatever is done interiors, you could do it also is called stucco. What is a chimney? In every house, we have a chimney. What is a chimney? Chimney is a place where it is a pipe that takes smoke. Okay, so whenever there is, we use fire for what? Food. Okay, that fire will go through how? This chimneys outside the house. What will happen if the chimney is not there in the house? The entire smoke will get into the house. Is that clear? So that is why it is called smoke stack. What is the meaning of chimney? It is called smoke stack. It is a pipe which takes smoke and combustion gases up from the air. It will take that and throw it to the sky. Okay, to the open air. Okay. So that the smoke does not come inside the house. That is called chimney. Repeat all of you. Chimney. C-H-I-M-N-E-Y. Chimney. Okay. Now, let us go to the next stanza. In this stanza, the poet is explaining the ingredients. What are ingredients? Materials. They are the materials that are used to what? To make the house. In order to make a house without a cement, can you do? Okay, without a paint, without cement, without brick, without a glass? No. Okay. The poet says that brick, stone, wood are used to make what? A house. We all use this for making a house. Without this, can you make a house? No. It also has window glass and corridor. Okay. It also has a window glass. Imagine a house without a window. Can you live in that? Or corridors? Corridors are the place where you can just adjacent to your room. Open space in the front. Okay. They are called the corridors. And you have a backside to your house that is called the garden. How much you love the garden? You want to go and see your plants? Is it not? Yes. You have, what do you have in the floor? You have tiles. Look at the spelling. Look into your house. What do you have in the floor? What are they called? Tiles. What is it called?
tiles. You have lot of designs also, and you have your house at your liking. Tiles of the floor, okay. And what do? You put fine paints, okay. You say, Papa, I want this color. I want this, this, this. You keep demanding, don't you? Then what is at the top? Raise your head and see at the top. What do you see? You see the roof. Okay, that is called the roof. What is the spelling of the roof? R-O-O-F, roof. Elevations. Elevations is what? Is completely many doors that give perfect look. See, if you don't have a door at all, how will you enter the house? You require a door. To come out of the house, you require a door. Bathroom should have a door. Toilet should have a door. Kitchen should have a door. Without a door, can you be? It will be like a godown, is it not? Without anything. Is it a godown without windows and this one? You always, why do you keep a window? Godown will not have, because air should not enter inside. They have to keep the granary, the insects should not come. So they keep it without windows. Can we live like that? What will happen? You cannot breathe, you will die. Yes. So we require lot of glass windows, you require doors, all these things are very important to the. It's only if you have all these things, you have everything, this is called a perfect house. Otherwise, it is called a imperfect house. You don't call it a house. This is an imperfect house. Or you say, this is a house under construction. While constructing, you don't have everything is like a stone lying there, glass lying there. It's imperfect. Okay. It is all these things together form a house. Thus a house is completely a non-living thing. Is there anything which is living? No. Does glass has life? Go and touch there. Does it breathe? No, it doesn't breathe. So all these things of a house is connected with non-living things. Okay. Thank you. By this I complete today's class. I'll do this next stanza in the next class. Okay, bye.